We are going to discuss Amazon EC2 application deployment. I am Walchand Bingi, working as an assistant professor in CSE department of WIT Solapur. At the end of this session, student will be able to configure application by using EC2 service, and they can also deploy application by using EC2 service. So small revision based on Amazon EC2. So what exactly Amazon EC2? Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud provides scalable computing capacity in the Amazon Web Service Cloud. It also eliminates your need to invest in hardware upfront so that you can develop and deploy application faster. You can use Amazon EC2 to launch as many as or few virtual servers as you need to configure security, networking, and manage storage. It enables you to scale up or down to handle changes in the requirement or spikes in the popularity, reducing your need to forecast traffic. So these are some of the advantages which you get with Amazon EC2. So I give one example. That is web application. Suppose you want to develop a site for yourself. Now, what is the requirement? You will use some technology to develop a website, either Java or ASP.NET. Assume you used Java. Then by using Java technology, you will develop JSP or servlet pages. So your site is created. Now, where you will host your site? On some web server. Web server can be in the form of hardware and software. Web server in the form of hardware, that means you need to purchase one high-end configuration box, maybe quad-core processor with 8 GB or 16 GB RAM, and with operating system, either Windows or Linux server version. Once you selected hardware as well as operating system, you need to install Apache Tomcat on that operating system. Assume you selected Windows server operating system and you need to install Apache Tomcat on it. Now, in order to make it live, what you need to do? You need to register for domain name, either on GoDaddy or some other similar site. So once you get domain name and once you get space to host your site, you can make that site live. So what you need to do, whatever code you develop, you upload it on the web server and make it live with the configuration which is advisable according to the requirement for securing the website. Once you've done that, your site will be live. So story behind this is you have spent money on your hardware. You have spent money for purchasing operating system. You have spent money for purchasing Apache Tomcat. Everything you spent. And you made your site live. Now, in order to solve this or in order to save the cost of the operating system and the hardware, or whether you don't know how much traffic will be coming to your site, the best advisable option is to use Amazon Web Services. So in Amazon Web Services, you can go for Amazon EC2 service on which you can host your site. So in last session, we discussed how to create Amazon EC2 service. Again, what you do, you go to Amazon site, sign into the console, sign. Once you sign it, again you create EC2 service. Enter username, password, So here you can create EC2 service. So what you do, launch instance, which was discussed previously. Now how many instances you want to create? One, by default it is one. I created one instance. Network, by default this is a network. Subnet preference, according to your requirement of network you can configure here, or you can go with the default if there is no particular requirement. Next, add storage. So by default it is take 30 GB as the default secondary storage, 30 GB. Then next, add tags. It is required when you are working with multiple applications. Here it is not required. Then you click on next, configure security. Then next, create a new security group if it is required. See, here by using this RDP protocol, you can connect to your server. And this is the protocol TCP. And this is the port number 3389. And you can select from which source your server will be accessed. You can say anywhere. So from anywhere your server will be available. Then you click on review and launch. So these are the the configuration details, and it is giving one warning also to improve your instance security. You can add your security group. So say in order to make your server secure, you can add security group, which we'll discuss in next session. So we have created the instance. Now once you click on it, you can also say create a new key pair. I'll say role download key pair. So it has been downloaded. Key pair for this launch instances. So you can go to that. What does it mean? You have created an EC2 instance. Now these are the configuration details. IP address is 54.202.62.143. Now by using this IP address, you can connect to that server. Now how to connect to the server? You directly go to run. Here you type mstsc. Okay. You click on OK button. Here you type the IP address 54.202.62.143. So these are the credentials which are required in order to log in that. Once you enter those credentials, you will be logged into that server. So this is how we can create instances, and we can connect to that particular instance by using remote desktop connection. So this is how we can create EC2 instance. Once you connect to that instance through remote desktop connection, there you install whatever applications which are required and you make your site live. Now once you've done this, what you do? As we know, this is our chargeable service. First I'll stop this service. Yes, stop. Then again, what you do? Terminate it. Yes, terminate. So this is how we can create EC2 instances and we can deploy applications. We can connect to that EC2 instance by using RDP protocol and RDP and TCP, and we can configure deploy applications. I'm signing it out. So what you do now, pause this video for some time and answer this question. Is EC2 service free from Amazon? No. However, some basic services are free with restricted features, as we have discussed. These are the some of the references for my video.